Hello and welcome to this presentation on accelerating your backups and recoveries with Quest CoreStore. My name is Adrian Meyer. I'm a Senior Product Management Consultant and Technology Strategist at Quest. In this presentation, you'll learn how Quest CoreStore can accelerate and optimize your backup data all the way from its source to the cloud. So let's get started. So what is CoreStore? Well, CoreStore is a software-defined secondary storage solution that provides deduplication, compression, and encryption technologies. It's platform agnostic in terms of which backup solution. It supports up to 13 of those. It has unique protocol accelerators. It includes replication, encryption for in-flight and at rest data sets. It has a level of multi-tenancy to stop data bleed. It includes secure connect WAN technology, allowing secure replication and a level of resilience over higher latency WAN links. It also has a cloud tiering technology and a performance tier as well, providing cloud storage solutions as well as high performance recovery. It also includes a new technology called Object Direct, which we'll look at a bit closer a bit later in the presentation. We also have an archive tier as well, which can leverage longer term cold storage in the cloud. So overall, the idea of CoreStore is that it saves you money, reduces your storage costs, and also helps to complete your backup strategies, getting data offsite with replication and tiering solutions. So CoreStore is different to most deduplication solutions. Most of those are tied to a specific hardware. And CoreStore is not like that at all. CoreStore is completely software defined. So you can actually even have this as a binary that you can install yourself. It will run on hardware of virtually any vendor out there in the marketplace. It can run in a virtual machine. It can also run in cloud. So you can either build your own solution or we can help build one for you wherever you actually need to run that solution. So how does CoreStore integrate with Veeam? So let's take a quick look at this. Here's a simple layout with a couple of proxies installed just to help load balancing data sets. So the first thing we do is replace the target with CoreStore. So once the target's set up and running and added into Veeam, we can actually then think about how we're going to move the data sets. We have a small piece of software that we install on the proxies. And this piece of software is what we call our rapid plugin and enables us to actually do the acceleration of data sets and provide source-side deduplication for all data coming out of those proxy servers. So when we start with our first backup job, it will even notice any data we've already got stored in the same job and actually start removing data straight away from the network. And the next time we run another job, and it doesn't have to be the same one, it can be any job, all of the data you already have stored is compared with any new incoming data. So if the blocks look the same, then we'll just remove those. So they don't actually have to travel across the network at all. Now, what does this do? Well, this obviously reduces the amount of network traffic that we have. But more importantly, it provides you with more bandwidth available at the target storage, which then in turn allows you to do more in the same amount of time. And of course, if you want to do more, you have also the ability to improve your recovery point objectives as well by getting more done. So once we have the data stored in CoreStore, we can start thinking about moving that out to cloud. One of the important things to do is to understand the costs and how we can actually use CoreStore to crush those cloud costs for you. So let's have a quick look at a CoreStore instance that has data stored in it already. So here you can see we've ingested over 150 terabytes of data into this particular CoreStore instance. It's deduplicated and compressed that, and it's storing it very, very well in around about 4.3 terabytes of storage. So it's done a great job at the first element of actually reducing the amount of data we have stored. So if that ingested 150 terabytes, I can actually choose which data I want to send out to cloud. So in this piece, in this particular server instance, we have around about 29 terabytes of that 150 plus terabytes that we wanted to push out to cloud. And we further deduplicate that and we further compress that down. So we actually then get to see that data set being really reduced. And eventually that data set then that gets moved out to cloud is very small indeed. So we've gone from 29 terabytes down to around about 66 gigabytes. That also includes a metadata map construct as well, that allows you to recover any kind of data should your CoreStore instance actually fail. We can reattach it to another one and you have access to your data again. So tiering to the cloud with CoreStore is very, very easy. It's completely automated. So how does this work with Veeam? Well, you can set up your Veeam proxy servers in your environment, just as you would normally. Install the rapid plugin if you want to accelerate the data sets across the network, and actually install your CoreStore servers. Now, in this example, we actually have some that are on-site and off-site. One of them is running hardware, and one of them is running in a virtual machine. So first, we then take our data set in its large format, and then we start doing our backup jobs. We get our source ID duplication, and our data starts flowing into CoreStore. Now, with that solution that's off-site somewhere else, you might want to replicate that in, and it will use any data you have stored in your local one as an offset to data it needs to move from outside, which means you're going to get source ID duplication as part of the replication as well. We only need to move the blocks that are unique. And now we take the point of view of saying, okay, well, if you want to tear that off to cloud for longer storage, then you can from either of those instances. You can either take the replicated data and tear it, or you can tear it from its original source on either of those. And as you can see, we support directly 5 cloud providers, plus we also support generic S3 storage too. So if you want to keep that on site, you can. So that's tiering done. So let's look at replication. Replicating off-site to cloud is a different thing altogether. So let's see how that works. So here we have exactly the same setup as before with our proxies and our CoreStore instances. No change there. So the big difference now is I'm not going to start tiering and I'm not going to replicate between my two sites. I'm going to take each of these and replicate to a CoreStore instance that's running out in cloud. Now you can run CoreStore as a virtual machine in cloud with managed disks, exactly the same as you would as if you're running on premises. But you can also take the option of running CoreStore in cloud and leveraging object storage for its main storage repository, which is far more cost effective than using managed disks. Then in this way, you can replicate data sets and have a true complete copy of all of your backup data offsite in the cloud in the most cost effective way. So in a way, when you look at it, CoreStore actually enables us to deduplicate data using native cloud storage. And then if you want longer term regulatory copies, you can still cloud tier off of there as well if you want to keep something somewhere else. Also inside CoreStore, along with its cloud tiers, there's also a performance tier as well. The performance tier is very, very important. If we look at the construct of CoreStore with a set of normal disks, we can actually add different types of disks into CoreStore. So we can add some SSD disks inside here. We also have some very advanced algorithms on restoration of data sets. So we take these SSD disks and we declare them as being in the performance tier. This means you can actually do your source side backups again as exactly as you would normally, but you can determine which ones are the most important for your business. Put them in that SSD tier into the performance piece. We can then think about how we want to restore the data sets. If I want to do an instant recovery with the SSD disks and with the algorithms, then you can do an instant recovery directly from the deduplicated data sets. So there's no need to have non-deduplicated disks sitting there idle. So you have no compromise in the fact that you can deduplicate everything that you want to store. So that high-speed recovery is very important to get things back up and running again, directly out of the deduplicated storage system. And of course, we also think about tiering too. When the cloud tier is in use and data sets are pushed out there, when we want to restore things, we have to think about what we have. So what we do is we actually look at the data sets that we have already locally. And if we need to fill any gaps after that, well, then we just pull that from the cloud tier. So we're only filling in where we need to, which reduces egress costs as well. All of this data can be encrypted at rest as well. So all the data that's held in the cloud tier, in the performance tier, and in the normal kind of storage tier, well, that can all be encrypted. So effectively, you get short-term high-speed recovery for instant recovery piece, medium-term storage for local availability, long-term object storage for regulatory requirements, all in a single solution. So if you want to learn more, you can hop on over to quest.com/QS to have a look at CoreStore, or quest.com/Veeam to learn more about how these two products integrate. I hope you've enjoyed today's short video, and thank you very much for your time.